students, good morning and welcome to the new episode of our English class. In the previous episode, we completed our third chapter and today we are moving on to the fourth lesson. Our fourth lesson is whatever happens is for the best. Whatever happens is for the best. You will be an optimistic person. Don't show any pessimism. You will be an optimistic person. Whatever happens in our life will be for the best. Think like that. Then there is no negative thinking in our mind and we will be always positive. That is the chapter's content. That is the chapter's content. You all heard about Birbal and Akbar. You all heard about Birbal and Akbar. Akbar is a powerful king. Emperor. Akbar is a powerful emperor and he had 9 ministers in his court. Akbar is a powerful emperor and he had 9 ministers in his court to assist him in state affairs or the affairs of the country. And Akbar had 9 ministers and they were known as Navaratnas. And do you know who are the 9 ministers of Akbar? Do you know their names? Yes, it is a task for you or it is an assignment for you. You find the names of 9 ministers in Akbar's court. There are 9 ministers in Akbar's court and find their names and write it as an assignment and you send it to me in WhatsApp. Okay. And here, whatever happens is for the best. Whatever happens in our life is for the best. Think like that and then you will be very positive and then there no negative thought will come to your mind. Okay. Do you know there are 9 jewels? They are 9 jewels. 9 ministers in Akbar's court is known as 9 jewels. Akbar is the great emperor. The great G-R-E-A-T. Great emperor. E-M-P-E-R-O-R. What is the right word of Malayalam word for emperor? Chakravarti. Akbar is a great and powerful emperor and there are 9 ministers in his court. 9 ministers are there in his court. In Akbar's court, there are 9 ministers. M-I-N-I-S-T-E-R-S. 9 ministers are there in Akbar's court and they were known as 9 jewels. 9 jewels. J-E-W-E-L-S. That means 9 Ratnas. 9 Navaratnan. 9 jewels. They were known as N-A-V-R-A-T-A-N. Navaratnam. They were known as 9 ministers, 9 jewels. They were known as 9 jewels in King Akbar's court. Birbal was one among them. One of the 9 was Birbal, who was the minister, who is one of the 9 ministers of Akbar's court. Birbal. B-I-R-B-A-L. He is a wise and a clever man. Birbal is a wise and a clever man. Birbal. B-I-R-B-A-L. Birbal. Find the names of the other 8 jewels and list them below. Here is 8 blanks are here and you find the other 9 ministers except Birbal and write the names in this place and take a photograph and send it to me. Okay. Emperor Akbar. E-M-P-E-R-O-R. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. Wise meaning clever. W-I-S-E. Wise meaning clever. W-I-S-E. Wise meaning C-L-E-V-E-R. Clever. C-L-E-V-E-R. Clever. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. He was called Akbar the Great. What is the name? What did people call him? Akbar the Great. The people called him Akbar the Great. Akbar is known as Akbar the Great. And the people of his kingdom loved and respected him. The people of his kingdom, the people in the kingdom of Akbar loved and respected him. Kingdom. K-I-N-G. K-I-N-G-D-O-M. Kingdom. Kingdom. K-I-N-G-D-O-M. Kingdom. Loved and respected. R-E-S-P-E-C. R-E-S-P-E-C-T-E-D, respected. R-E-S-P-E-C-T-E-D, respected. Birbal, B-I-R-B-A-L, Birbal. Then wise, he is wise. And clever, kingdom, Akbar's kingdom. Then respected, people of Akbar's kingdom respected and loved him. What are the things we studied in the first paragraph? People of his kingdom loved and respected him. He was a just ruler. J-U-S-T. Just means he is very just and he did not show any partiality to any people in his country. He is a just ruler and with a good sense of humor. He is also, Akbar is also having a good sense of humor. H-U-M-O-U-R. Humor. What is the meaning of humor? Humor sense. Phalidam. Humor. Phalidam. H-U-M-O-U-R, humor, H-U-M-O-U-R. Akbar is a king and he is a just ruler and he is having a good sense of humor. Akbar is having a good sense of humor. He had a great respect for learned men. He had or he showed great respect for learned men. That means wise and clever men who are well educated. He had a great respect for well-educated people in the country. Okay, what are the things we studied in the first paragraph? Akbar is a great ruler and he is known as Akbar the Great. There are 9 ministers in his court. They were known as 9 jewels or Navaratnas. One of the 9 jewels were Birbal and he is loved and respected by the people of his country. Akbar is a just ruler and which is the other thing, he had a great respect for well-educated people. He had a great respect for well-educated people. Okay, I'll read the first paragraph once more. You please listen to the text, page number 28. Page number 28. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. He was called Akbar the Great. The people of his kingdom loved and respected him. The people of his kingdom loved and respected him. He was a just ruler. He was a just ruler with a good sense of humor. He had a great respect for learned men. I'll read it once more. You please listen. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. He was called Akbar the Great. The people of his kingdom loved and respected him. He was a just ruler with a good sense of humor. He had a great respect for learned men. Okay, this is the end of the first paragraph and we are going to the next. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. Though everyone respected him, although the people of his country respected him, they were afraid of him. They were scared of him. That means Akbar is a strict ruler. That shows his strictness. Okay. Though everyone respected him, all the people of his country loved and respected him. Though they loved him, they were afraid of him. That means they were scared of him. Afraid. A-F-R-A-I-D. Afraid. Listen to the spelling. A-F-R-A-I-D. Afraid. Though all the people in his country loved and respected him, they were afraid of him too. They were afraid of Akbar the Great. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. Too means, that is also added to it. If nobody did not obey his commands, if the people of his country did not obey his commands, what will happen? Commands or went against him in any manner, he would not think twice before punishing them. Akbar the Great is a just ruler. He is not showing any partiality to anybody. And the people of his kingdom loved and respected him. Though the people of him loved and respected him, or people of his country loved and respected him, they were afraid of him too. They had a fear towards him. They had a fear towards him. What is the reason for the fear? What is the reason for the fear? They feared Akbar, or they were afraid of Akbar, because if somebody commit a mistake, or if somebody disobey his commands, obey means anusarikkuka. If somebody disobey his commands, what will happen? He will not think twice. If somebody disobey his commands in any manner or in any respect, he will not think twice. He will take necessary decision to punish them. He will take necessary decision to punish the people who violate or disobey him. People who violate the laws or disobey Akbar the Great. Okay. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. The next one is a large sentence. You understand the meaning of it. If anybody did not obey his command or went against him in any manner, that means if any people in his country or any ministers in his country violate the rules of his kingdom. Violate means disobey. Violate the rules of his kingdom or disobey the commands made by, the orders made by Akbar, what will happen? He will not think twice. Akbar will not think twice. He would not think twice before punishing them. He will punish the people who violate the laws without thinking twice. Without thinking twice. That is the content of this second paragraph. Okay, look once more. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. If anybody did not obey his commands or went against him in any manner, he would not think twice before punishing them. He would not think twice before punishing them. I'll read that two paragraph together. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. He was called Akbar the Great. The people of his kingdom loved and respected him. He was a just ruler with a good sense of humor. He had a great respect for learned men. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. If anybody did not obey his commands, commands means orders, commands, or went against him in any manner, he would not think twice before punishing them. Okay, is it clear? The next paragraph. He had many wise ministers. Akbar had many wise ministers. Listen to the spelling of ministers. Listen here. MINISTER. Minister, then plural, ministers. 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 He had many wise ministers. In fact, he had 9 ministers who were known as Nayan Ratna. Ratan meaning 9 precious jewels. In fact means in the fact that he had 9 ministers who were known as Nayan Ratnas, or Nayan meaning 9 precious jewels. Precious means valuable. Precious. What is the meaning of precious? PRECIOUS. Precious. What is the meaning of precious? Valuable. Precious means valuable. 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 Precious means valuable. He had many wise ministers. In fact, he had 9 ministers who were known as Nayan Ratnas, meaning 9 precious jewels. Among them was the greatest musician Tansen. One of the 9 ministers was Birbal. The other one was Tansen. T-A-N-S-E-N. Tansen. The other one was Tansen. T-A-N-S-E-N. Who was the first one? Birbal. Birbal. B-I-R-B-A-L. Then who was the second one? Tansen. T-A-N-S-E-N. Second one. Birbal was a clever man. Tansen was a great musician. Tansen was a great musician. Among them was the greatest musician. Musician. Spelling. Check the spelling. M-U-S-I-M-U-S-I-C-I-A-N. Musician. M-U-S-I-C-I-A-N. Musician. Among them was the greatest musician Tansen. It is said that when he sang certain ragas, unlit lamps will automatically light up. It is said that when he sang certain ragas, there were so many ragas in music. Ragas, R-A-G-A-S, ragas. And when he sang certain ragas, certain, C-E-R-T-A-I-N, certain. When he sang certain ragas, R-A-G-A-S, when he sang certain ragas, what will happen? When he sang certain ragas, the unlit lamp, unlit means it is not lighted, unlit, unlit, it is not lighted. The unlit lamp was, lamps, sorry, lamp, it is not lamp was, lamps. Unlit lamp was get lighted by hearing the ragas of Tansen. By hearing the ragas of certain ragas by Tansen, what will happen? The unlit lamps will get lighted. The unlit lamps would automatically light up. The unlit, U-N-L-I-T, unlit, listen to the word, U-N-L-I-T, unlit lamps will automatically, O-A-U-T-O-M-A-T-I-C-A-L-L-Y, automatically get lighted. That means there is nobody to lighten the lamps, but it will automatically, that means naturally, automatically means it will naturally get lighted by hearing the ragas of Tansen. Okay, is it clear? Tansen is one of the 9 jewels in Akbar's court and he is the greatest musician, and while he sang certain ragas, the unlit light will get lighted automatically or naturally. That is a speciality of the musician Tansen. That is the speciality of the musician Tansen, and Tansen is one of the 9 jewels in Akbar's court. Tansen is one of the 9 jewels in Akbar's court. Unlit lamps would automatically light up, and when he sang the raga for rain, it would start raining. And the Amrutavarshini raga is for rain, Amrutavarshini, and it is for using, it is used for getting rain, it is used for getting rain. And when he sang the Amrutavarshini raga, what will happen? It start raining, it start raining. That is the speciality of the greatest musician Tansen. Tansen is, who is Tansen? Tansen is one of the 9 jewels in Akbar's court, and he is the greatest musician. What is the speciality of Tansen? The speciality of Tansen is when he sang certain ragas, and the unlit lamps will get automatically light up. That will get automatically light up, and he can sing certain ragas to get rain. He gets rain gets started when he sing certain ragas. He had many wise ministers. In fact, he had 9 ministers who were known as 9 Ratnas, meaning 9 precious jewels. Among them was the greatest musician Tansen. It is said that when he sang certain ragas, unlit lamps would automatically light up, and when he sang the raga for rain, it would start rain. It is the raga used for getting rain, Amrutavarshini. Amrutavarshini is the raga which is used for getting rain. Okay. The next paragraph. Birbal, one of the 9 jewels, was known for his wisdom. Known for his wisdom. Wisdom means cleverness. Wisdom. W-I-S-D-O-M. Wisdom means cleverness. Wisdom means cleverness. Birbal is also one of the 9 jewels. Birbal, then which is the other one? Tansen. Who is the other one? Tansen. The next one is Birbal. Birbal is also one of the 9 jewels, and he is known for his wisdom. Birbal is known for his wisdom. Birbal, one of the 9 jewels, was known for his wisdom. He was also the king's favorite. Birbal was also the king's favorite. F-A-V-O-U-R-I-T-E. F-A-V-O-U-R-I-T-E. Favorite means most liked one. Favorite means most liked the one. Favorite. Who is the favorite of Akbar? Emperor Akbar. Birbal is the favorite of Emperor Akbar because of his wisdom. Birbal is a wise man. Birbal, one of the nine jewels, was known for his wisdom. He was also the king's favorite. His way with the words always left the king amused. A-M-U-S-E-D. Amused means surprised. Amused. A-M-U-S-E-D. Amused. Amused means wonder or surprised. How Birbal is using his cleverness. How Birbal using the words. That is W-I-T, wit. How Birbal is using his wit. That make the king amused. That make the king. Who is the king here? Emperor Akbar. That make the king amused. Okay. Let us look at the first part of this chapter. Okay. From the very beginning, you listen to the text. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. He was called Akbar the Great. The people of his kingdom loved and respected him. He was a just ruler with a good sense of humor. He had a great respect for learned men. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. If anybody did not obey his commands or went against him in any manner, he would not think twice before punishing them. He had many wise ministers. In fact, he had nine ministers who were known as nine ratnas, meaning nine precious jewels. Among them was the greatest musician Tamsin. It is said that when he sang certain ragas, unlit lamps would automatically light up, and when he sang the raga for rain, it would start raining. Birbal, one of the nine jewels, was known for his wisdom. He was also the king's favorite. His way with words always left the king amused. Okay, let us have a look at what are the tough words or difficult words from this topic. Listen here. Afraid. A-F-R-A-I-D. Afraid means scared. Afraid. A-F-R-A-I-D. Afraid. Scared. Then ministers. M-I-N-I-S-T-E-R-S. Ministers means the people who help to assist in the ruling. The ministers means the people who help the king to assist in the matters of state, matters of the kingdom. That is ministers. Spelling M-I-N-I-S-T-E-R-S. Ministers. Then the next word is precious. P-R-E-C-I-O-U-S. Having great value. Valuable. Having great value or valuable. P-R-E-C-I-O-U-S. Precious means valuable. Then which is the next word? Tamsin is a name. Tamsin is one among the nine ratnas in Emperor Akbar's court. Then next one is musician. Musician, spelling M-U-S-I-C-I-A-N. A person who is having the capacity to music is called a musician. A person who is dedicated to music is called a musician. Then certain, C-E-R-T-I-N. Certain means sure, certain. C-E-R-T-I-N. Then ragas, R-A-G-A-S. There were many ragas in music. And the next word is unlit, U-N-L-I-T. Unlit, it is read as unlit. Then automatically, A-U-T-O-M-A-T-I-C-A-L-L-Y. Automatically means naturally. A-U-T-O-M-A-T-I-C-A-L-L-Y. Automatically means naturally. The next word is wisdom. W-I-S-D-O-M. Wisdom. Next is favorite. F-A-V-O-U-R-I-T-E. Favorite. F-A-V-O-U-R-I-T-E. Favorite means most like the favorite. Then amused. A-M-U-S-E-D. Amused. Okay. Then which are the points we studied from this first part? First one, Emperor Akbar is known as, Emperor Akbar is known as, can you say the answer? He is known as Akbar the Great. Akbar the Great. Emperor Akbar is known as Akbar the Great. Akbar the Great. And what is the speciality of him? He was a just ruler and he was loved and respected by the people of his kingdom. He was, second point, he was loved and respected. He was loved and respected. And respected, R-E-S-P-E-C-T-E-D, respected by the people. He was loved and respected by the people. Next point. What is the next point related to Akbar? He is a just ruler. Third point. He was a just ruler. He was a just, J-U-S-T. He was a just ruler. R-U-L-E-R. He was a just ruler. He was a just ruler. And which is the other points? Which are the other points? He had a good sense of humor. Fourth one. He had a good sense of humor. Can you describe Emperor Akbar, or can you explain the character of Emperor Akbar? Emperor Akbar is known as Akbar the Great. Can you write a paragraph about Akbar the Great? Emperor Akbar is known as Akbar the Great. First one. Then second one. He was loved and respected by the people. He was loved and respected by the people. Then he is a just ruler. Next one. He had a good sense of humor. He had a good sense of humor. S-E-N-C-E. Sense of humor. H-U-M-O-U-R. He had a good sense of humor. There were 9 ministers in his court. Next point. There were, fifth point. There were, T-H-E-R-E, there were 9 ministers in his court. 9 ministers in his court. Ministers in his court. C-O-U-R-T. Which is the next point? An important point. Though Akbar is a lovable person. We had already told that Akbar is loved and respected by the people. Though he is a lovable person, what is the other quality? What is the opposite quality of lovable? He is, the people were afraid of him. Though he is a lovable person, people were afraid of him. People means the people in this country. People were afraid of him. A-F-R-A-I-D, afraid of him. Though he is a lovable man, people were afraid of him. Can you write 5 sentences about Akbar? Listen here. Emperor Akbar is known as Akbar the Great. Emperor Akbar is known as Akbar the Great. The next one. He was loved and respected by the people of his kingdom. Akbar was loved and respected by the loud. It is not L-O-U-D, louder. L-O-V-E-D. He is loved and respected by the people of his country. And his next point. He is a just ruler. He is a just ruler. Then he had a good sense of humor. Akbar had a good sense of humor. The next one is, there were 9 ministers in his court. And though he is a lovable person, people were afraid of him. Though he was a lovable person, the people were afraid of him. Okay. This is all about Akbar. And we are going to study what are Navaratnas or 9 jewels. Navaratnas and 9 jewels. 9 jewels. N-I-N-E-J-E-W-E-L-S or Navaratnas. N-A-V-R-A-Rattas. The word is Navaratnas. Navaratnan is the ministers of Akbar. Navaratnas. 9 ministers are, first point, 9 ministers are there in Akbar's court. Ministers are They are in Akbar's court. They are in Akbar's court. A K B A R. Akbar's court. 9 ministers are there in Akbar's court. Then next one. They were known as 9 jewels. 9 jewels. J E W E Yes, jewels. They were known as 9 jewels. Birbal is one among them. The first one is Tansen. Tansen is one among the 9 jewels. Tansen is one among the 9 jewels. 9 jewels. And he is the greatest musician in Akbar's court. Tansen is the fourth one. He is a greatest musician. M-U-S-I-C-I-A-N. Tansen is a greatest musician. Tansen is a greatest musician. And fifth one. Birbal is also one among the coin. Also one among the 9 jewels. 9 jewels. Look at what do you know about the 9 jewels? There are 9 ministers in Akbar's court. 9 ministers are there in Akbar's court, Emperor Akbar's court. And they were known as 9 jewels or Navaratnas. They were known as 9 jewels or Navaratnas. And Tansen is one of the 9 jewels in Akbar's court. Tansen, he is a greatest musician. What is the quality of or peculiarities of Tansen? Tansen is a greatest musician, and while he sang certain ragas, while Tansen is singing certain ragas, what will happen? The unlit lamps will get lighted automatically. The unlit lamps will get lighted automatically. And when he sang the raga for rain, which is the raga for rain? Amrutavarshini is the raga for rain. And when he sang the raga Amrutavarshini, it gets started to rain when he sang Amrutavarshini, the rain will start, and he is the greatest musician in Akbar's court. The second one among the 9 ratnas is Birbal. He is known for his wisdom. Birbal is known for his wisdom. Wisdom means cleverness. Birbal is known for the cleverness of his cleverness, and the way he uses the word, or the way he uses it with his wit, W-I-T. The way Birbal uses his wit made the king, that means made Akbar get amused, made Akbar get amused. And Birbal is known for his what do you know about Birbal? Birbal is one among the 9 ratnas in Akbar's court. He is known for his wisdom, and the way he uses his wit or cleverness, he get amusement to Emperor Akbar, get amusement to Emperor Akbar. And Birbal is the favorite of the 9 ratnas to Akbar. Birbal is the favorite minister of Emperor Akbar for his wisdom, for his wit, W-I-T. Birbal is the favorite of Emperor Akbar. We studied this much portion, and we can stop here, and I will read today's portion once more. Listen here. Emperor Akbar was a wise ruler. He was called Akbar the Great. The people of his kingdom loved and respected him. He was a just ruler with a good sense of humor. He had a great respect for learned men. Though everyone respected him, they were afraid of him too. If anybody did not obey his commands or went against him in any manner, he would not think twice before punishing them. He had many wise ministers. In fact, He had 9 ministers who were known as 9 ratnas, meaning 9 precious jewels. Among them was the greatest musician Tansen. It is said that when he sang certain ragas, unlit lamp would automatically light up, and when he sang the raga for rain, it would start raining. Birbal, one of the 9 jewels, was known for his wisdom. He was also the king's favorite. This way with words always left the king amused. We can stop here. And which is the work given to you? The work given to you is find the names of the 9 ministers in King Emperor Akbar's court and write them in the blanks provided. The most important thing is text reading. You should read a text as many times as possible, and that will make you familiar with the content of this chapter. Okay, let us stop here and continue in the next class. Thank you.